Hey folks, welcome to Quantsapp and welcome back to yet another video. Do you use options open interest as a key indicator for your options trade? Then this video is for you. You should watch this video till the very end, because in this video, I'll tell you 5 secrets about options open interest data. So let's start this video by understanding options open interest data in one of the most simplest ways. So when we talk about options open interest data, okay, so just understand the profile, the risk profile of the buyer and the option seller. So now when we talk about option buyer, he takes a limited risk, he has a leverage of winning unlimited profits, and also he pays a very small amount of premium to enter in that trade, so his take is very, very small. On the other hand, when option seller sells any option, he has an undefined loss on his head. Second thing, he knows that his profit is going to be very small. Okay, so whatever premium he receives, that is going to be his maximum profit. Third thing is, option seller, they have to pay big margin. Okay, they have to bring in more money in the market. They have to pay big margin, to the exchange to let them enter in that trade because of the unlimited loss profile they carry. That is the reason whenever we look at options OI data, okay, options OI data, we look at it from the writer's perspective. Okay, the reason being, the stake which is, the stake which writers take, okay, they take a big stake in the market. That is the reason we analyze the options OI data from a seller's perspective. Also, they take a negative reward to risk, right? The maximum profit is 1 rupee. They can lose, whatever the premium is, the maximum profit basically, right? They can't earn even beyond that. So that is the reason we look at the options OI data from, the seller's perspective. So the first thing is, wherever we see huge call writings happening. So now let's say whatever the stock is, you see something like this getting formed, and this is where the highest call writers are. Okay, so this is where the highest call open interest is. That means highest call sellers, they have sold the call options at this strike in expectation that the stock might not be able to surpass this level. So this is called as the resistance. Okay, so the highest call open interest strike price is called as the resistance. So this is the first simple thing what you should know. Second thing, wherever you see the highest put open interest, so wherever you see, in the option chain, or wherever you look at the options OI data, wherever you see the highest put, jahan par bhi sabse zyada put writers hai, wherever the highest put writers are, that level instrument, the participants are not expecting the instrument to go down below that level. Okay, it might go sometime, but it might again reverse, because sabse zyada jo put becha hai logon ne, wo yahi strike par becha hai. So this acts like our support. So the first key takeaway from this video is, which is the highest call OI strike price. Okay, the highest call. Okay, this is your resistance. And highest put, this is your support. Okay, so this is the first key takeaway what you should take from this particular video. So now where you can find options OI data, so you can navigate to option chain tool in Quantsapp, and you can easily find that out. So this is Excite Industries. So if you see, these are the strike prices. Left hand side is showing us call OI, right hand side is showing us put OI. So now we have simplified analytics with simple color codes in Quantsapp. You see the biggest green bar, that is where the highest call writers are, and you see the biggest red bar, that is where the highest put writers are. So you can use this. Let's say I'll navigate to Nifty. You can search for your desired instrument from the search symbol. So this is Nifty. So in Nifty, you can change the expiry from here. So let's say 15 December expiry. So in this particular screen, now what you can see is 18,600 is the strike price where the highest call writers are, highest put writers are, even, and 18,600 is the strike price where the highest call writers are. So Nifty, it is at equilibrium. Okay, there is a tug of war going around at 18,600, but where the second highest put is, the second highest put is placed at 18,500. So in Nifty, this Nifty is right now at equilibrium, because that is where it is trading right now, somewhere around the zone of 18,600. But this will act like our support, this will act like our resistance. But right now, if you see, even this put strike, it has significant open interest, right? So in this type of situations, what we will do, I will tell you that thing, Okay, so what you will we will do is whenever the stock or any index, whatever it is, okay, any script, as long as it is liquid, if it is exactly where, you know, at the ATM itself, if the highest call and put strikes are exactly where it is, okay, at the ATM, what you will do is you will wait for some kind of move to happen either on the up or the downside. So what I mean by this is, so let's say the green thing, okay, what I'm drawing right now. So let me just clear this. Okay. And let's say this. Okay. So let's say these are call writers. Okay. And let's say the red box which I am drawing, let's say these are put writers. Okay. So let's say these are put writers. Okay. So here I go. So these are put writers. Just assume that. Now what you should do is, and let's say the black line which I'm drawing is price. So what you should do is, whenever it is at equilibrium, whenever the highest calls and puts are placed at same strike, what you will do is you will wait for market to either break out on the upside or market to break out on the downside. Okay, this is the first thing. Second thing what you will do is, if the breakout is on the upside, okay, let's say if the breakout is on the upside, you will wait for these call writers to unwind. Okay, you will wait for unwinding to happen on the call. That will indicate you that this call writers are trapped and the market might move up from here. Okay, so this is the first thing what you will do. On the other side, if let's say there is a breakdown happening, let's say if market goes down, then what you will do is you will wait for these put writers to unwind. Okay, you will wait for a trigger that these put writers are unwinding, then we might see that again a down move happening in the market. So whenever there is an equilibrium, okay, whenever the stock is, the ATM is the strike where highest calls and puts are, which is called as, you know, the equilibrium. So what you will do is you will wait for, you know, a move to happen plus unwinding. Okay. Unwinding, if the move is on the upside, you will wait for unwinding on call. If the move is on the downside, you will wait for unwinding on the put. Now coming to the third secret, which is if you just focus on XI industries, then see what is happening in XI. So let me just go home and let's just go to option chain once again. Just check this out. So in XI industries, what happened is, see, it is the only one strike, okay, only one strike, which is, you know, having huge call writing. See, only one strike is having huge call writing. So that will act like a pivotal resistance. So if you are participating in a bullish trade in XI industries, 200 is the level what should be your target typically. Why? Because the highest call writers, they have sold the options at that particular strike itself. So now the thing is, whenever you see on an option chain, only one big strike is getting formed. And if the trend that you are carrying is bullish, then the biggest strike, the biggest call strike will act like your target. Okay. So now what I mean by this is, so let me just draw, or let me just show by example of Bank Nifty or some other script where the scenario is getting created. Now just remember what is happening in XI and then let's say Bank Nifty. Okay. So now you see there are clusters in Bank Nifty, right? There is no huge pillar of either call or put. There are clusters happening. So whenever there are clusters, it might, you know, stop there and it will keep on moving in a slowly and gradual manner. But whenever there is a single call or single put getting created, that will act like your target or stop loss. Okay. So let's say if biggest green, okay, or let's say single huge call slash put, okay, this will act like your target or stop loss. Okay. Now let's say you're participating on a bullish trade. Highest call will act like your target and the highest put will act like your stop loss. Only if the strike prices are very big and single, okay, single, there are no clusters getting formed, okay, and the vice versa for the put side. Coming to the fourth point, whenever you see that, okay, there is a cluster getting formed, okay, whenever you see that there is clustered OI which is getting formed, that will indicate that market will move up slowly and steadily, okay, it will face some struggle or there will be some thrust happening in the market. Market will not move very, very swiftly. Okay, if it is a single call or single put, market might move really, really fast, either on the up or on the downside. But whenever you see something like this, right? See how many put writers are there. So market will, so now see, simple. On the downside, market will take a support at this level first. Okay. Then it will take a support at this level, and then it will take a support at this level, and then it will move up. But now if you see in Bank Nifty, what has happened is there is one big call strike, and later on, there is no significant call which is, you know, ready to defend it. No huge call writing is there so that this Bank Nifty can be defended on the upside. So, you know, the moment this level is broken and these call writers, the moment they unwind, Bank Nifty might see a good move happening on the upside. The reason being that, you know, there are no multiple call hurdles to protect this particular zone. So whenever we see clusters happening, okay, whenever we see that there is a cluster happening, that indicates that, okay, that, you know, this is more like a range bound thing. Or maybe, you know, if something like this, wherein there are multiple put hurdles, the support is stronger. If there would have been multiple call hurdles, the resistance would have been strong. So clusters indicate range bound thing and slow movements. Okay. So there would be movement, okay, on the downside. It wouldn't be the case that Bank Nifty would never fall. Okay, it would fall, but it will take support multiple times. Okay. Multiple, okay, hurdles. This is the fourth point. Coming to the last, and you know the important point about options OIS, that PCR, the put call ratio, okay, a contrarian or a sentimental indicator which will help us in finding out if the market is overbought or oversold. So this thing will tell you that, you know, it will tell you whether the put writers are more or the call writers are more. So how it is calculated, it is very simple. Total number of put OI divided by total call OI, and then you will get a ratio of it. Okay, so it is divided by total puts by total calls. So now if you just see, I will just show Nifty. What happens is that this typically will mean revert. See, this was at bottom, right? This will typically move along with the market. But see, whenever put call ratio topped out, so the green line is showing us YPCR, open interest put call ratio, and the orange line is showing us the futures price. So see what has happened. On this day, on 9th of December, put call ratio it bottomed out. Right, 18,583 was market, and market, you know, the put call ratio, it bounced from the bottom, and market also bounced from the bottom, right? So whenever you see the put call ratio, it is getting bottom out. Now likely is the chance that market is also forming a bottom. So on the lower side for Nifty, it will differ for all the different instruments. 0.7 is the level, okay, 0.7, 0.69, in that trajectory is somewhere put call ratio forms a bottom and market rebounds. Okay, on the top, then you see 1.55, right, in this zone as well. Okay, whenever the market, whenever the PCR tops out, even the market tops out. So if you want to see a bigger data, then you can see that as well. Let's say July. Okay, so just see this thing. See, put call ratio topped out, market also topped out, market collapsed. Put call ratio topped, market topped, it collapsed, right? And it gives you indication a bit earlier as compared to, you know, the day on which the top will happen, right? It will give you slight indications a bit earlier. The reason being, the participants who are trading in the market, they are smart enough, right? They will not wait for an exact top to get formed. They will let go some movement, and, you know, accordingly, the call and put writers will create their positions, right? So why this happens? Because, you know, obviously, just think it in one simple way. Someone who has bought at this point, okay, or someone, let's say, has sold put option at this point, he will try to book his profit, right? He will try to cover his put, due to which the put positions, the put writings will go down in the market, and the support will be broken and the market will collapse. Okay. So this is the thing. So it happens generally because of the market getting overbought or oversold. So you can use OIPCR to identify if the market is overbought or so oversold. So this typically use it to identify, you know, if the market is overbought or oversold. If the PCR is at bottom, if OIPCR is getting bottomed out, right, that is the time you will try to find out an opportunity to buy. If the OIPCR is at top, and if Nifty is in a bullish trend, then, you know, you will wait for a dip to happen, and then you can participate on the long side. So these are few secrets which I had about options OI data. So, you know, definitely you should start using it and start observing it, because options OI, you know, you should use it in a systematic way. It will give you, you know, a lot of good moves in the market. And yes, folks, if you found this video useful, do hit the like button, do hit the subscribe button. Bye bye, take care, and see you all in the next video. Happy trading.